Action.
Good morning and welcome to day 19 of our 21-day prayer and devotion. It's been quite a journey. So far, we have learned so many things throughout all these days. As we coming to the closure of our devotions and prayers, let's look at a few more things that are really important for us to learn. We've been talking about for past few days about the importance of prayer in our lives, the power of prayer. And we talked about how do we pray and what are the conditions when we pray to get an answer from God. Today, we're going to look at how does God answer. Over the next few days, let's look at how does God answer our prayers. And that is also necessary for us to understand. How does God usually answer our prayers? Luke chapter 1 carries an interesting story of an old man called Zechariah, who was a priest in the temple of God, and his wife Elizabeth. Both of them are old, very, very well into their age. They were expecting a child. They've been praying for a child. And then as the years went by, they probably lost all their hope in their expectation of a child. And then one day, out of the blue, suddenly the angel of the Lord appears to Zechariah while he was on his duty at the temple and speaks to him and prophesies him about a child who is going to be born to them and through them. And that person would be the voice that calls out from the wilderness about the coming Messiah. That incident is an interesting one in Luke chapter 1. While we look at it in a detailed manner, we kind of start realizing how God usually answers our prayers. Today we're going to talk about the first way God answers our prayers is this. God answers our prayers in His own time. We need to understand that. You must learn and be willing to let God answer in His own time. We usually pray and expect God to answer immediately. But we need to understand that we need to let God answer according to His schedule, His timetable. Whenever God thinks it's the best time to answer the prayer. The fact is God often delays answers to prayer. He doesn't answer everything immediately. Why does He withhold the gift sometimes for a period of time? When He holds like that, sometimes it becomes really hard for me to believe that God is going to answer my prayers. But if God sent an angel to come and speak to me face to face and say, Chaitanya, I'm here to tell you that God answered your prayers, I think I would believe it, right? I would be pretty certain that God has answered my prayer and it's going to happen. Zechariah is an amazing guy. When the angel comes to him and says, God has sent me here, I am Gabriel, the archangel of the Lord, and you are going to have your prayer answered. Zechariah looks back at the angel and says this, how can I be sure of this? I mean, that's interesting. How can I be sure of this? When he is the ultimate skeptic, why didn't he believe it? Why didn't he believe even when an angel is standing in front of him and talking to him and saying that you're going to have a child? It's because chances are he stopped praying for a child. That he would have stopped praying that prayer years before. If you read the passage, casually it looks like this. He went into the temple, he prayed, and the angel of the Lord came and said, your prayer has been answered. But the fact of matter is this, that I'm sure Zechariah and Elizabeth had given up their prayer years earlier. Because Zechariah says, I am an old man. My wife is well into years. Well, that's kind of a diplomatic statement. He's basically saying, we gave up praying on that prayer long back. So the angel said to him in verses 13, you would say this, don't be afraid, Zacharias. Your prayer has been heard. Your prayer had been heard. The tense of the word heard literally means it already happened. It happened long time ago. That God heard your prayer the first time you prayed. He heard your prayer immediately. There's no problem with it. Taking time for your prayer to get to God. It's there instantly. It's already there. But sometimes it delays the giving of the answer for over a period of time. That is one of the hardest things that we can learn. We have to learn. Kids find it difficult to understand the difference between no and not yet, right? It's hard for them. They'll say, Daddy, can I have a cookie? And we say, not yet. They might go into a fit like state and, as if I'm never going to give them a cookie. But, it's because immature people don't understand the difference between no and not yet. The mark of a maturity in a Christian is how long can I wait? That's a mark of maturity in life. Babies always have to have it immediately, but a mature person can wait. I talked to a person once who said, I tried prayer. I prayed for 2 weeks and nothing happened. So I've given up on prayer. I've lost my faith in prayer. No, you haven't lost your faith. You lost your patience. That's what it means. You spell faith as P-A-T-I-E-N-C-E. Faith is patience. Why does God delay answering our prayers? Usually it's because God, he needs to prepare us first before he answers the prayer. He needs us to get ready. He wants to bless us in order to give that blessing to us for which he has prepared us. That's the point. If my child asks me if he or she can drive my car, I would simply say no. And when I say no, it actually means not yet. Because you need to grow up. You need to be physically strong enough, tall enough. Your age needs to catch up with you. You need to be legal age before you can actually sit in my car and start driving it. God waits many times for us to answer our prayers, for us to grow up. The frustration we have is that we usually think we are ready before God. God actually thinks that we are ready. We think we are ready to receive an answer, and God is actually waiting for us to mature. Habakkuk's big question when he asked why, how long, God? Have you ever said that? How long are you going to let me go through this, God? You wonder if God sees everything that I'm going through today, and if God really cares about me, about what I'm going through, and if God has a power to help me to get out of this problem, get out of what I'm going through. What's up, God? Why can't you answer my prayer right now? Why can't you just, get me out of there? It's a less legitimate question. If he sees and he cares and he's got the power to do something about it, why doesn't he? Why doesn't he work it out? The answer is this, that he usually wants us to change first. He wants us to change our attitude. He wants you to change your attitude. God is more interested in making you mature than he is making your life easy. Instead of going out and saying, Lord, change this situation, maybe you should start by saying, Lord, change me. Lord, change me in this marriage, not my spouse. Lord, change me in this job. Change me in the way that I do my job. Once you're in line, then God can go ahead and answer your prayers. Do you have a financial difficulty? Maybe God is saying, I want you to learn right attitude about money. Or I want you to learn to be a good steward of what is given to you, little things. Then I can help you out. Maybe God is saying, first you need to change in your attitude. Then I can start working in your problem. The fact of the matter is this, that God is never late. His timing is always perfect. We may think he's late, but he's never late. God's delays are not God's denials. That you need to remember. Not yet does not mean no. How do I pray then when my prayer is being delayed? How long should I pray when my prayer is being delayed? I prayed and it's not been answered immediately. What should I do then? Well, let me give you three things, three suggestions for you to, with regards to how long should you pray, right? Number one, pray till you get an answer. Now, obviously, when you get an answer, you stop praying. Or pray till you get your assurance. That's the second one. That means sometimes God does say this to us. Hey, I'm going to give it to you. You can be sure of it. Once God says that to you through the scriptures, through, you know, the prompting in your heart as you meditate on the word of God, once you have an assurance in your heart, then you can stop praying about it and start acting on it. Mark 11 says, Mark chapter 11, when you pray, believe that you have received it and you will get it. If that assurance comes into your heart, you got it. You can stop. You believe it in advance. So you keep praying until you get it or until you get an assurance. Number three, you continue to pray until God reveals to you that it is not His will. Basically, that God says, no, it's not what I want you to do. And God will tell us. There are times when we think what is good for us and we pray for it. We think it's godly thing, it's a good thing. But sometimes God says, no, it's not my will. Like David wanting to build a temple, spoke to Nathan. He was building a temple is a good thing. Till God told him no, David planned for it, prepared for it, was ready to go ahead and build the temple. So when God said, no, it's not my will for you to do that, David understood that and he stopped. So it's a very simple thing. Till you figure out that God is speaking to you directly and saying no, or you become uncomfortable, there's this peacelessness about what you're praying for, stop praying about it. So you pray until it's getting done, or you pray until you get an assurance that it'll get done. You pray until you hear from God saying, no, it's not my will, stop praying for it. But you must wait till God does things at His time. So in order to receive an answer from God, you and I must be willing to let God answer in His own time. What is God delaying in answering your prayers? If there is a delay in answering your prayers, maybe God is saying, wait. Maybe you should start seeking God and ask Him, God, can I have a clarity about is it your will or not? And you will find your answer. God bless you. Have a wonderful day.